It's often not easy to decide what exactly range we should use in a for loop, whether it should be I smaller than n, smaller than n minus 1, or something similar. We will practice this today. Let's start with this problem. Given a string, check if it contains three equal characters in a row. Given string YouTube, we should say that yes, there are such three equal characters in a row. It's not a difficult problem to solve in, for example, C++. We need some kind of for loop and comparison between three characters, s of I, I plus 1, and I plus 2. Those will be just three indices to compare. I plus 1, and I plus 2. What's very easy to mess up here is we can get an out-of-bounds error, because if you check I plus 1 and I plus 2, you might go outside of the bounds from 0 to n minus 1, because this is how indexing works. So if you try I being here at this very last position in a string, then I plus 1 will give you a runtime error. Then what exactly should we put here? Some people guess, or they know what to do, what to put here, whether it should be n minus 2, n minus 3, something like that. I don't really recommend guessing, so instead let's try to understand it. If we are looking, what is the last triple we should consider? Because the very first triple is this one. For I equal to 0, you will compare it with indices 1 and 2. What is the very last one? Those three. This should be I, then this should be I plus 1 and I plus 2. Then what is this last I that you should use and compare with the next two indices? Well, the very last index is n minus 1, assuming that n is length of the string. Then, okay, this is n minus 1, this is n minus 2. Then this last position where I should be is n minus 3. This is how I always figure this out. So I don't even use smaller than character here. I find smaller than or equal to easier to understand. And I put here n minus 3. This will check for each of those positions from 0 to n minus 3 whether character on this position I is equal to the next two characters, I plus 1 and I plus 2. If so, let's say we just need to return true that yes, there are three equal characters in a row. Otherwise, at the end, we return false. It would be equivalent to typing I smaller than n minus 2, but I find this version easier. Let's now make this slightly more difficult. Let's check if there are k consecutive equal characters where k is given. This time we cannot just make an if with just comparing I with I plus 1 and I plus 2, and also this part will be more difficult. Indexing first. When I think about a sequence and its indices, I don't care too much about the content of this sequence. Sure, there are some characters, maybe x, x, I know, c, b, b, but those do not matter too much. Indices matter. The very last index is n minus 1, here is n minus 2, and so on. And just like before, let's think, what is the last index from which I want to start a block of size k to compare if those k characters are the same? Well, it will be, I believe, n minus k. Let's verify that. If we have here 1, 2, 3, and so on up to k, then indeed, this should give us k elements. So this index n minus k is the last one where, starting from here, we should keep comparing, because this is a candidate for k equal characters in a row. For each of those positions in range from 0 to n minus k, we should check, starting from this position I, do we have enough equal characters? How will we check that? There are multiple ways for that, and we'll see that in code in a moment, because it's now impossible to just handle that with an if. But we already figured out this part. We will just put here n minus k, which matches the previous solution. A moment ago, we had here three equal characters, and we used n minus 3, so it makes sense that now it's n minus k in a general case. To verify if my solution is correct, I'm going to solve and submit this problem from Code Forces, where given a binary string, I need to check if there are seven equal characters in a row, which is slightly easier because we can use the fact that those are zeros and ones, but I will try to make my code work in a general case if there could be arbitrary alphabet here from A to Z. A is s length, just to make the code nicer. And now, for every starting position from 0 to smaller than or equal to n minus k, I assume that there is some kind of k. Oh, k is 7 here. K is 7. I plus plus. Starting from here, try 7 characters. And we can do it with a very long if. S of I is equal to S of I plus 2. And you can do this. I don't really recommend it. Instead, of course, it wouldn't work if k was given in the input. But here we know we need 7 elements. So I could write down this if with 6 conditions inside. Instead, I'm going to make a for loop here, which is not the only solution. What kind of for loop? I guess starting from I and ending somewhere. Again, I'm going to use this smaller than or equal to. I will check if si is equal to sj. And then I will do something. Now, what is this? If I want k elements, it will be, for example, I plus 1, I plus 2. This would give me 3 elements. If I want 5 elements, I need this. These are 5 elements. So starting from I need to end at I plus k minus 1 to give me k elements. I plus k minus 1. Notice that I'm making this work for arbitrary k, even though this problem only says k is equal to 7. I could just put 6 here, but I prefer my code to be nicer, more general. If equal, then what? I can increase some kind of counter here. Counter is 0. That's one way to do it. So I'm checking if all characters are equal. There are 7 of them, k of them. If counter is equal to what, k, then what do we need to do? Print yes and finish. Otherwise, multiple times yes would be printed. At the very, if there were many strings, otherwise no. Should be fine. It compiles. Let's verify this. First test. Second test. Okay, let's submit. That's the advantage of not just testing it yourself in your computer. When you submit to online platform like CodeForces, if it passes indeed, you can be certain that it's correct. Not 100%, but it should be. Other solutions involve using substring function to just compare if starting from this position, the substring of 7 characters is equal to this. We can even use find to automatically find a substring. But the point of this exercise was for us to practice for loops and the range of those for loops up to where you need to iterate to avoid runtime error. Another solution was that very long if. Or also finding block size, finding how many equal characters in a row we have. Like here we have 2 zeros in a row, 1 1 in a row, 2 zeros in a row, and so on. And that's your homework, actually, to solve in CSCS problem repetitions, which is this one. Once you solve it, then you can go back to CodeForces football and solve it again using the same solution. I will not spoil more right now. And if you want something slightly more difficult, you can also try LeetCode 187 repeated DNA sequences. Links to problems are in the description. Make sure to implement all those solutions, submit them, and I thank you for watching this video. See you next time. Bye.